Wake up and get started with Breakfast Television.
Hey, Eddie's fans, it's game day, and there's no bigger fans of FC Edmonton than Breakfast Television. Trust me, our whole team tuning in for this one. Thanks for joining us here on City. We are a half hour away from kickoff. Of course, Minnesota United FC, the Eddies rolling in on a two-game unbeaten streak with 10 points in their last five games. Lance Lang and, of course, Chad Burt both named to last week's NASL Team of the Week. You want to talk momentum? This team's got it. We hope it means more seats in the stands, more Edmontonians checking out the game live on location at Clark Stadium. And if you can't be there, remember, we'll have it live for you right here on City. And of course, on Tuesday's Breakfast Television, we'll bring you all the highlights following a best of BT on Monday. Thanks for joining us. Go Eddies!
Wake up and get started. Breakfast Television, weekday mornings at 5:30 on City.
Thank you very much, Ryan. And let's get game day started with a look back at the week that was in the NASL Week in Rewind.
Week 7 of the North American Soccer League fall season was filled with results that shook up the standings. The San Antonio Scorpions have reclaimed their spot atop the NASL fall season standings, while FC Edmonton climbed four spots with a win over the weekend. Carolina Railhawks and FC Edmonton ascended to the top half of the standings, passing the likes of New York and Fort Lauderdale. NASL spring season champion Minnesota United FC failed to stay atop the fall table after playing to a draw with the Cosmos. The Railhawks slid into the fourth spot in the championship, passing the Strikers and Rowdies in the NASL combined standings. Week 7 featured four matches on Saturday night, with the first one kicking off at Schuert Stadium in Hempstead, New York. Forward Christian Ramirez stepped up to put home his league-leading 13th goal of the season to give United a 1-0 lead. Playing down a man for practically the whole game, the Cosmos fought back and got the goal they deserve midway through the second half when forward Mad Stokelyan finished from the near post.
And they know the slump that they're in. Likewise, when they're on a hot streak. Down the left side, Johnson. In for Stokelyan! And there's one! The drought's over! 1-1!
The Tampa Bay Rowdies were looking to gain ground in both the NASL fall and combined standings, but the Carolina Railhawks proved to be too tough of an opponent on Saturday night. Railhawks goalkeeper Akira Fitzgerald stood tall all game long, making his first big save on Keith Savage near the tail end of the first half. Midway through the second half, with the game still scoreless, the Rowdies looked as if they would finally break the deadlock, but it was Fitzgerald coming up big again, this time denying Georgi Kristov. Fitzgerald's heroics allowed his teammates just enough time to find a game winner, with T. Shipalani taking a pass from Daniel Jackson and firing it high into the net to seal all 3 points in second half stoppage time. With Minnesota United drawing in New York, that opened the door for the San Antonio Scorpions to reclaim their spot atop the fall standings with a win over the visiting Atlanta Silverbacks. After a scoreless first half at Toyota Field, Scorpions midfielder Cesar Elizondo set his team on their way, putting away a rebound early in the second half. Later on in the game, the Scorpions earned a trip to the penalty spot after Silverbacks goalkeeper Eric Atti knocked over Elizondo in the box. Midfielder Walter Restrepo would be the one to step up, narrowly beating Atti, who guessed the right way.
Fans on their feet.
San Antonio is up by a pair.
Almost immediately, the Silverbacks pulled one back, with Honduran midfielder Junior Sandoval firing a beauty past Josh Saunders from over 20 yards out. It wasn't enough, however, as Scorpions would hold on for the 2-1 win. For the second time in 3 weeks, Mother Nature decided to treat NASL fans to a late-night special. After a rain delay of more than 2 hours, Indy 11 and Ottawa Fury FC kicked off just before 10 p.m. on Saturday at a rain-soaked Carroll Stadium in Indianapolis. Ottawa had a chance to go 1-0 up inside 9 minutes, but Christian Nicht was there to deny Nicky Patterson's penalty kick attempt. Fury FC would get another chance from the spot in the second half, and this time it was forward Tom Heineman taking the shot. Indy 11 equalized in the 84th minute, thanks to a good finish from Jamaican midfielder Don Smart.
The bicycle. Smart going timer!
Yes!
The fans that stuck around through the weather delays would be disappointed, though, as midfielder Sinisa Ubiparapovic immediately answered Indy's goal with one of their own, and it would prove to be the game winner. And that's the weekend that was in the North American Soccer League. Week 8 fall season action resumes this Friday when the Strikers host the Scorpions.
Welcome back to FC Edmonton Soccer here on City. Now, Free Footy is a great initiative that helps to bring the game to underprivileged children here in Edmonton. The Eddies taking part in a Free Footy clinic very recently, and our own Bridget Ryan taking part as well. Take a look.
Giovanni Caboto Park, and there is a gentleman that knows this square, this pocket of grass so very well. Tim, welcome to Breakfast Television.
Thank you for having me.
I want to say, Tim Adams, what you have done, I walk into this and I see kids screaming, they are running, they're getting athletic, but they're also incredibly happy, joyful. You've done all of this. Free Footy is your brainchild.
It's my full-time volunteer job, but I love it. Every single day I come home from these games and I just feel like, you know, you have those little things in your day and you complain about, you whine about them, and you see the kids here who've, a lot of them, gone through a lot. And I never get a complaint. It's always high fives after the game. It's always huge hugs. Parents will come and hug me and it's like, okay, I know what I'm doing and why I'm doing it and how important this is. So it just means so much to me as well to be part of it.
It's awesome. Let's talk about what Free Footy is exactly. You and FC Edmonton have joined forces and are changing lives.
Yeah, we started this about 5 years ago, as you said, and there was 4 teams and 80 kids then. And now there's 32 teams and nearly 1,000 kids. So this is just 6 teams playing here in this park. But all across the city today, there are games going, 16 games at once. And FC Edmonton has been a huge supporter of us by having players. You can see players out there today, professional players coming out and helping our kids, talking with our kids, telling them about the game, but also telling them about just how important it is to be active, have fun, enjoy the game, not be the best at the game, but enjoy the game.
Not to interrupt, but you come by this passionately, and quite honestly, you were teaching in the area and you saw the need for after-school soccer. You also saw that there was the need for everybody's brother and sister to come and play. You saw the need here for kids to have this sport within their neighborhood, this inner city neighborhood.
Yeah, I was just coaching at Macaulay School there, volunteer coaching, and I had a junior high team, and their little brothers and sisters had to come as well because they were the eldest. The kids on my team, they had to bring them. So I'd go out on the field with 20 of my players and then 20 brothers and sisters. And so I started thinking, okay, there's got to be a way around this to make sure everyone can play. So we started a team for them, invited a few more teams, and then it blew to 32 teams. And the main thing is we partner with schools because the bell rings, the kids play.
Right.
One of the hugest challenges people forget, aside from the equipment and the registration fees, which you can get covered through other great organizations, is the transportation. How do you get to a game when mom and dad are working 2 shifts or mom and dad don't have a car?
Right.
You can't.
Right.
So the bell rings, the schools walk them over here. Most of our games, probably 90%, are within walking distance. If they're not within walking distance, we pay for the buses. And all the problems are solved. Equipment, fees, transportation. Great coaches.
Great coaches, great people, great spirit, great mood. Oh my gosh, do you see? I'm talking. Look at this. This is, like you said, this is this is only 6 of the 32 teams. Tim, you're amazing. We're going to check in with you again, though, before we are finished with our morning here, because I want to give you a sense of how excited the kids are, though. I mean, like this child here. What is your name?
Veronica.
Veronica, what a great name. Okay, so Veronica, how cool is this right now? You are getting ready to go play a game. You're getting coached by FC Edmonton.
It's awesome.
Yeah? Are you learning how to be a wicked soccer player?
Yeah.
Is that kind of what you want to be maybe when you grow up? Oh, awesome. All right. These guys right here, what is your name, sir?
Etienne.
Etienne. All right. And how is it to be coached by FC Edmonton?
Awesome.
Is it awesome? Okay. Can we see a couple of moves, perhaps?
Mm-hmm.
Have they taught you something? A thing or two?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Wait, are you prepared to show that right now on television?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Okay. Here he goes. I'm going to follow him. Let's go, Rich. Got the ball. He's lining it up. Steals. Oh! I'll put it up there. Okay. Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, this is an aspiring young soccer superstar. Oh, confident, solid. Not. Look at this. This is what I'm talking about. Free footy is changing lives. It's one of the greatest programs, and of course, coupled with FC Edmonton. It doesn't get much better than this, my friends. We're here at Gianna Kubota, and we're going to continue to be here all morning long introducing you. It's all you, buddy. Take it. Take it. We'll be back. More BT after this. It's called Free Footy. And I'll tell you, it is a fantastic program. Tim Adams is the genius behind this program, taking inner-city schools and basically bringing them to the field here at Giovanni Caboto Park. And guess what? They have not just the coolest sort of team that they're playing against, they have the coolest instructors, members of FC Edmonton. Kareem, hello, welcome to Breakfast Television.
Hi, everyone. It's some feeling to come out today and work with the guys and see some of the kids, the smile on their faces, and what Adam is doing here is actually great for the community.
Awesome. Do you guys love the fact that you're getting coaching from professional soccer players?
Yeah, man.
You, of course, know that the work here that you're doing, you're changing lives by empowering them by playing soccer with them and giving them your best pro tip.
Yeah, of course, you know, making sure the kids are having fun, learning how to kick a ball and score some goals and think positive.
Are you a net?
No, but today I'm the goalie, so watch out, Lance.
That's what I mean. Like, are you actually are you a net today and these guys are taking shots on you?
Yeah, they are, and they're pretty ruthless. Yeah, they don't really care.
All right, so let me ask you, because this is a little, first of all, we will get to some soccer playing in a mere moment, but you guys, this is an amazing opportunity to actually get some coaching by some of the country's greatest soccer players. How do you feel about this? Like, is it exciting to play with these guys watching your back?
Yeah, it's really exciting, and it's like great for the community to just let us be kids and play soccer.
Awesome. And it's, I mean, I'm guessing that you guys, in terms of soccer, does anybody here have a future in soccer? Any of you go, oh, yeah?
No,
what makes you think?
You got the moves?
Yeah, I got the moves.
You got the moves and the grooves?
Yeah.
So you got the moves, but then you got, like, the grooves.
Yeah.
Are you prepared to walk the talk, sir? What is your name?
Ayoub.
Ayoub? Okay, Ayoub, you can't just, like, smack it down here on BT. You gotta show your stuff. Are you prepared to show your stuff?
Yeah.
All right. What are you gonna talk him through here? Because he's gonna do a little bit of a drill, a little bit of fancy footwork before he actually gets to Curry.
Actually, what he's gonna do, he's gonna dribble the ball both sides with his right foot, learning to play with his left foot also. And then he's gonna get an opportunity to score on our goalie, Milan Roberts. So.
Opportunity does not mean it will happen. It's all you. You ready? Okay, everyone back up. That's what we're talking about. Super cool. BreakfastTelevision.ca, more information. This is an opportunity of a lifetime for these kids. And it's fifth year, free footy. One of the greatest programs, I think. Okay, it's all on Ayoub. Okay, you guys.
Actually, what he's going to do, I'm just going to demonstrate it for him. He's going to go on his right foot. Ayoub, you're going to go on your right foot, yeah? And then you put your foot, you go on your left foot, around the cone.
Around the cone, okay.
Right foot. Opportunity
right
to
here.
Pick each side.
Ayoub, you think you can do this?
I'll try.
That's all we ask. All right, everybody, stand back. There he goes. This is what I love. This program is awesome. You know, it's like Mother Nature loves this program too. The rain, it's holding off. The wind, it's whipping up. But everybody feels invigorated and empowered. As you can see, this is awesome. Okay, you guys, a little bit of focus, a little bit of support by Ayoub. Okay, ready?
Ayoub,
let's do it.
Nice
control. All right, going over. All right, making his way around. There he goes. Okay, he's got his schooling him. Okay, will he do it? Oh, yeah. Rebound. Go for it again. Oh! Oh, my God. Go get him. Hug it out. This is awesome. This is what it's all about. We'll be back. More BT after this.
All right, there's still plenty of action coming your way. Don't go anywhere because right after the break, we have FC Edmonton Soccer right here on City.
The early cross, and there's a beautiful diving header. Terrific goal by Daryl Fordyce. Good strike, and it's there! Lance Lang has buried it. Good cross in the middle, and there's Fordyce, and it's a beauty.
Welcome to Edmonton. It's a beautiful August day for the Eddies' biggest match of the season so far. They're up against the spring champion, Minnesota United, today, and they've been on a tear, taking 10 points from a possible 15, scoring goals, playing well, and playing with confidence. Lots of buzz around Clark Stadium today as the Eddies make a push for the playoffs. Good afternoon, I'm Gareth Hampshire alongside Steve Sandor, and what a turnaround in the last couple of weeks, Steve.
Yeah, we get to the point now where if FC Edmonton can take 3 points from Minnesota, extend the winning streak to three games, they'd be only 3 points out of that overall fourth place spot, which is a playoff spot in NASL. That's how tight this race has become, and if they win, they really pack up that fall season race as well. So it's a match with all sorts of playoff implications as we head down the stretch.
Back in action after an excellent 2-1 victory over Fort Lauderdale last week. Let's take a look back at those highlights in a game in which Lance Lang caught fire for the Eddies. Lang playing well on the left wing.
Yeah, and he sets it up here for Richie Jones, just cushions it in. And here we see Lance Lang left alone on the left side. Look at him pick the corner here. Right inside the post. And then a kiss for his fiance after the goal.
Coach Colin Miller hoping that his team can continue their good form against Minnesota today.
The guys should be ready for it. If they're not, there's something wrong with them. But a game that we'll have to be at our best to beat Minnesota. We've had some really good games against them. They're a well-organized, well-disciplined, very experienced team with some players in key areas that can hurt you if you go to sleep.
And the Eddies in with a chance of the playoffs now, definitely in the hunt. Let's take a look at where they stand in the North American Soccer League. And as Steve mentioned, 3 points today would see them right in the mix.
Yeah, it would put them within five of San Antonio. Remember, if they win, Minnesota United would stay at 17 points. So it really tightens it up. But in the overall standings, which has implications for those third and fourth playoff spots, a win today now would nudge them up to 3 points out. So one game out of that race.
As you can see in the table there, Minnesota unbeaten in the fall season so far. Let's take a look at what the keys to the game are if the Eddies are to continue their run with Steve.
And we really have one major key to the game today, and that's Christian Ramirez is here from Minnesota. He's got 13 goals this season, leads the league by a mile. The next best scorer has 8, to put it in comparison. Here we see him scoring on a penalty against the Cosmos. He's also designated penalty taker for Minnesota United. And you know, we can look at this matchup between arguably the two MVP candidates this year, between Christian Ramirez and Lance Lang of FC Edmonton on the left for the Eddies. And let's take a look, we had talked with Colin Miller earlier this week about what the team needs to do to shut down Christian Ramirez.
Albert and Beto will be well aware of his capabilities. I just don't want them to get into a wrestling match with him. I want them to play with cover and go and challenge a ball, but not into a wrestling match and bring fouls and free kicks against us in bad areas.
FC Edmonton close to having a clean bill of health. Let's take a look at the injury report brought to you by River Valley Health. Banner, the long-term injury, and Blanco close to getting back.
Yeah, he says he's about another week away with that MCL, something he hurt on a road game against the Cosmos a couple of weeks ago. But the coaches are being cautious with him, making sure that he's going to be 100% before he gets back.
It's FC Edmonton against the spring champion, Minnesota United. And the kickoff at Clark Stadium is coming up next.
Edmonton Soccer, starting now on City. Brought to you by City, The Fath Group, High Signs, and Earthwater.
Welcome back to Clark Stadium. We're just about set for kickoff. A big one this for the Eddies against the spring champion Minnesota United. And Edmonton full of confidence, attacking the goal to our left. And let's take a look at the first 11 that Colin Miller selected today. For the Eddies, Parker in goal, the back four of Edward, the captain, Watson, Navarro, and Moses. Midfield four, Noni, Rodales, and Jones, with Lang on the left, Chad Burt partnering Tomi Amiobi up front. And for Minnesota, very strong team, still unbeaten in the fall season with a 12-game unbeaten run. Hildebrandt in goal, Jordan, Diaz, Thiago, and Davis the back four. Pitch-Colan, Mendez, Giuliano, and Venegas in midfield. And Ibarra just behind. Christian Ramirez, the league's top scorer with 13 goals. Good conditions out there at Clark Stadium today. A nice sunny day, but it is a little breezy down on the pitch. 26-kilometer-an-hour winds, but nice, warm conditions. And the goalie matchups today. Lance Parker back in goal for FC Edmonton, taking the spot back from John Smith. And for the visitors, Mitch Hildebrandt.
Interesting matchup to see today, and I mentioned off the top in the pregame show that I think this is going to be a battle. The one thing to watch today is really the two guys I would have on my MVP ballot right now would be Christian Ramirez, obviously the leading scorer in this league, and then Lance Lang on the left side for FC Edmonton. What he's done, especially in the second half of the season for FC Edmonton, has been nothing short of remarkable, and he's been really the big key to the turnaround for this club.
Lance Lang out wide on the left, hoping to receive the ball quickly as Amiobi gets ready to kick off with Chad Burt, FC Edmonton in the white shirts, blue shorts, and white socks. Minnesota all in a light cyan blue color. And FC Edmonton get us underway. Jones pushing the ball straight away to Eddie Edward on the right-hand side. He'll stroke it to the captain, Watson. Everyone getting a quick touch of the ball. Navarro bringing it out of defense here. And finding Rodales. FC Edmonton playing with a lot of confidence lately. And you can see that in the goals they've been scoring, turning it around in the last couple of weeks. 10 points from a possible 15 for the Eddies.
We already see that Minnesota. Ramirez goes up, tries to challenge the defenders. He has a couple of men behind him, Pitch-Colan and I think in Jordan, who are behind and just looking to press as soon as Edmonton might get that ball to midfield. But they're really packing the midfield, Minnesota, making it hard to go through.
Poor ball from Navarro at the back, and it's intercepted by Mendes. And Minnesota getting their first spell of possession in the match. Here's Diaz. And now Thiago. Early passing move. Giuliano now moving the ball out wide to Diaz. Pitch Colan's up there to hold up the ball. Thiago again moving out as they try and weave play down that right hand side, but that's going to go into touch and will be a throw in for FC Edmonton.
Last time these two teams met in Minnesota, it was a 3-2 result for Minnesota, but Edmonton struck the crossbar off. Chad Burt, a deflected shot, the last kick of the game, and there was a real interesting incident earlier in the game where Eddie Edwards' deflected attempt, 99% of that ball got across the goal line. It might have been 100%. We don't know for sure. We'll never throw the referee under the bus on that one because too close to call, but Minnesota cleared the ball off the line. The referee didn't give the goal, and went right down the field and scored, which was ended up being a decisive goal in the game. And Colin Miller was quite disappointed. Not in the call, because again, it was too close to call if you take a look at the still shots. But the fact that his team was busy protesting the non-goal rather than marking as Minnesota went up the field that game.
Thiago again for the sprint champs. Drilled one forward long there, and it's nicely chested down. Good awareness by Navarro to snuff out that attack and winning a throw-in for FC Edmonton. Coach Manny Lagos for Minnesota, well aware of the turnaround in FC Edmonton's fortunes, speaking about the fact that he knows his team's playing against a different team than the one earlier this season.
Well, I think he even saw it in that game in Minnesota that while they won the game 3-2, he saw that Edmonton has some offensive teeth and that they gave up a couple, and he said the woodwork prevented them at the last second from giving up a third. So they will, they'll know now that Edmonton, it's not that team now that you don't have to worry about creating not a lot of scoring chances. Edmonton is scoring goals in bunches right now.
Richie Jones trying to rob possession on the right-hand side. Did well there, just crowded out by Minnesota, but he's back in there again trying to win it back. Good pressure from Jones in the midfield. Fresh from scoring a goal last week. Mendez linking up with Thiago. It's a long ball down the right channel, and it's well aimed for Venegas. He's appealing for a free kick, and he's got one. And this will be an early test for FC Edmonton.
Don't think Beto Navarro knew too much about that. He was turning as that cross struck him on the arm. But the official gives this one. Edmonton will have some early work to do, and you have to here always look out for Aaron Pitchgolan. He scored against Edmonton in the past with various teams. Just that height you have to watch. Brings that big body in on those set pieces.
It's going to be Justin Davis with the free kick on this right-hand side. 0-0 so far. And he drifts that one to the far post, left-footed. Diaz gets his head on it, but can't direct it towards goal, and it's gone as a touch. Goal kick for FC Edmonton.
You know, we talked about that breeze in the weather report, and it does blow and gust, and it does get quite strong, and we can see the flags now blowing out quite a bit. But I've noticed the flags have sort of changed direction sometimes. They're not always blowing out that way, so it's a tough win to judge, I think, if you're the players, because I think it is shifting around a little bit on them.
Rodales playing a ball out to the right-hand side. That will go into touch again. Throw in for FC Edmonton. Both teams trying to find a rhythm in this match so far. Ooh, Moses with a poor back pass, and there's a real chance for Minnesota here, and it's put wide of the post. Almost a gift as Moses played the ball back without noticing the danger, and that's a real let-off for FC Edmonton.
Absolutely, it's a let-off here. And of all the people you would want to have on that ball, I think that was Ramirez who didn't take that chance. NASL's leading scorer. You present him with that chance, his chance to round the keeper, but doesn't get the angle right. But yeah, Moses, his heart can start beating again because, wow, that was a heck of a giveaway.
The other end, Noni makes a good break. Good quick feet to work himself a corner kick, and FC Edmonton counter-attacking nicely there. And Lance Lang, a man full of confidence, coming over to take this corner.
But we could look at that maybe moment in the game as a big let off for Edmonton early, because really it should be 1-0 to Minnesota right now.
Lang's ball is high under the crossbar. Amiobi with the header. And it was a good, powerful one too. And he doesn't believe that the whistle should have been blown against him there. But the free kick is with Minnesota.
Yeah, Tomi Amiobi is a tall enough guy, but his leaping ability is something else to see. Last week we saw him out-leap Antoni Avich, the 6'5" Fort Lauderdale defender for a corner in the game. He headed it just wide, but boy, did he get height.
Navarro gets a head on that one, drops down in the midfield, but one in there by Jordan for Minnesota. And that's a nice, clever turn by Giuliano, and he's pinged a lovely ball inside the fullback as Minnesota attack here. Good recovery by Noni. Great pace to keep up with the marker. Clearance, though, intercepted again by Minnesota. Pressure once again from Richie Jones, but a little too much this time for the referees like it. Given to Minnesota.
I can't imagine FC Edmonton's going to love the first 7 or 8 minutes of this game so far. They haven't had enough of the ball, and again, look at that chance they gave up on a mental and physical lapse there, where they gave up that golden chance on goal, and luckily for Edmonton, they weren't punished for it.
Goal really gaping for Ramirez there, but just didn't get his foot hooked around the ball and couldn't get the angle. It was a difficult angle, but a very makeable chance
And Moses has to put that one out of his mind now and try and make amends for it.
I think it's one of those situations where you're a forward or any sort of attacking player and you almost don't imagine, can't imagine how much time you've got. It's also like, I've got this much time and space, and I actually think he could have taken another step towards goal or maybe settled the ball down on his feet and said, I'm just going to get my bearings here and actually square myself towards goal. Like you said, it's that not the greatest angle, but he could have squared himself at least towards goal and really got a shot on target rather than trying to hit it while moving.
Ramirez with 13 goals. League's leading goal scorer. But not on target so far.
And it's not close. Like, you look at that scoring race, it might be done now. Like, you have to think someone else in the race has got to come with 5 or 6 goals just to catch him where he is right now. And he's going to keep scoring. So that one might sort of be a done deal unless something radical changes the next 8 or 9 games.
9 minutes gone, goalless so far at Clark Stadium. FC Edmonton and Minnesota, that's going to be an easy one for Lance Parker to pick up. And he rolls it out to Moses. Moses, another back pass to Parker. And this one he drills up the right-hand side of the pitch. Noni won't get to it. Amiobi might. Good recovery by Justin Davis, and that ball drops for Rodales. Edward trying to thread that one up the right-hand touchline. One back by Minnesota. Nice touch from Pitch Colon. This is a good-looking break. And inside the fullback, there's a great run there. And driven just wide of the post by Venegas.
But again, Minnesota taking control of that ball in the midfield. Using that their numerical advantage they seem to have right now across in the middle of the park. And then able to spring Venegas for a cross there, and Edmonton's living very dangerously right now. You need to tighten that up. They need to get more possession in the middle of the park. Minnesota's winning the ball back too easily, and when they win it, you take a look, they're knocking the ball down and they're keeping possession.
Navarro coming across to make that timely interception, but it's given away by Rodales, and FC Edmonton just struggling to get a grip on this game at the moment. Here's Richie Jones. Back for Edward. Another free kick given, and Eddie's being pushed back by a very strong Minnesota team in the early stages of this match, although we've had no goals in 11 minutes.
You take a look at how Minnesota keeps possessions, how they're switching angles and how they're attacking different ways, sometimes down the wing, sometimes up the middle, sometimes coming up long, sometimes putting some passes together. You can see why this team has been so strong, why they were the spring champion. I mean, there's no illusions here, right? You talk to the FC Edmonton players in the lead up to this game, they know how good this Minnesota team is. But this is a big challenge for them. It's in a lot of ways. It's a statement game for FC Edmonton in the sense that if they can withstand this and they can get a result out of this, it sends a message to the league that this hot streak is for real, this team's turnaround is for real. That the last few results haven't been just a string of accidents. It really is a sign that this is a team to be reckoned with, but they need to put something together today.
Rodales caught in possession there, and Minnesota build again here, looking for a long-range shot. Parker just off his line, but no problem there as he backpedals to watch that one safely hit a touch.
I think Giuliano was a little bit selfish there. He had two runners on each wing that were making breaks down on a 3-on-3, and I think that time sliding a ball down the wing to one of those runners is the way to go and not to have a look at goal.
Watson's got to hurry to keep that ball in play. He's done that. He's going to play a long one forward towards Amiobi. Diaz watches that one closely. Pitch Colon, the captain, gets another touch. Minnesota riding a 12-game unbeaten streak, and you can see why in the early stages of this match. Looking very strong and starting very positively. Thiago again in possession. Nice. Just taking time to run that one across the back. Thiago again. Giuliano digs one out to the right wing. Lang will take this one, and he'll have a run at the defense here. The good pace from Lang. He's got around the back. Great ball into the middle. And that's the kind of form that he's been in. And it will be a throw-in on the far side, but that's really the best defensive spark we've seen from the end.
And that's all Lance Lang needs, is that half a second, that mistake, and he's able to jump by, and you can see how quickly he got by Jordan there, blew by him like he wasn't there. Lang has the ability to stay at pace, the ball at his feet, and then he puts in a low cross, it's dangerous. He had Tomi Amiobi running into the box, and how quickly he can turn around. And that's just how important Lance Lang has been to this FC Edmonton team. We've been seeing this fairly regularly over the last few weeks with those kind of runs and those kind of those chances down the left side.
Thriving since moving up to the wing and scoring last week and making the other goal, and is really playing full of confidence at the moment for the Eddies.
Another thing he does is he really pushes the right back back, that it makes it hard for that right back to attack. We saw Venegas get up a couple times here, but you get really worried about being exposed.
Here he is again, Lang, almost seized on another opportunity, and his pace could carry him through here. Amiobi's in the middle, Lang tries to find him, just overhit the pass, but Noni cuts it back in again, and there's the strike from Chad Burt. It's just gone behind. But Lang pressing back Minnesota again.
Better from Edmonton the last couple of minutes. They've had a couple of counterattacks that have at least forced Minnesota back, maybe forced them to be a little bit more honest. And again, you can look at what Lance Lang does to expose players, and that ability, that pace. If he can get that first touch, he can create some chances. His cross was a little bit long that time, but still, Noni was able to get it back across the box, so Burt could have at least a half chance.
15 minutes gone in the match, and it's 0-0 so far, Edmonton and Minnesota, as Navarro runs back towards his goal. And again, it's a slightly risky back pass, but Parker deals with it and finds Lang. Rodala's playing this ball up long. Amiobi makes the turn. Might still make something of that, but headed back to his goalkeeper in the end by Greg Jordan.
The defenders, FC Edmonton, are making a lot of friends with Lance Parker with the back passes he's been getting in the first few minutes. One led to a very good scoring chance, and another is very closely averted a scoring chance.
Somewhat of a late flag there for an offside decision against Ramirez, but FC Edmonton have the ball, and Watson and Navarro talking to each other. Colin Miller looking from the sidelines, perhaps with some thoughts about FC Edmonton's first 16 minutes in this match. Could be 1-0 down, but Ramirez missed a sitter. And at the other end, the Eddies playing themselves back into the match, thanks to some good attacking breaks by Lance Lang. Home team trying to lift the Eddies. Edmonton, they're trying to find Lang over the top. I wonder if that ball just getting held up in the wind a little bit. The wind definitely driving into the faces of FC Edmonton as they attack from right to left. Noni's ball into the box, cleared there by Minnesota. Good tackle by Rodales, gets down to Rob Minnesota at possession. Good challenge on Mendes there. It's a throw-in for Minnesota United.
You're right, Gareth. The wind, too, is a little bit unpredictable because it's gusting. It's not consistent. So, you know, 1 minute it's not in your face, and the next minute it is. So, and again, I've seen the flags. They tend to be moving around. I wouldn't necessarily say it's a swirling wind, but it doesn't necessarily seem to be consistent. That's what makes it difficult for the players in terms of direction and when it kicks up. It makes it a bit of a challenge.
Minnesota, a promising attack here for them. And rattling one off the crossbar is Justin Davis. So another good chance for Minnesota. But Lance Parker, part of his armory is the crossbar, and it saved the Eddies here.
Good left foot there by Justin Davis, and he's unlucky. They flooded forward down that side with a numbers. Three players coming right down that left side, overloading it, and creating all sorts of problems for Michael Noni on that side, and for Eddie Edward. And it created an opening for Justin Davis to have that volley. And really, Edmonton now is, you can almost say they're fortunate not to be down two, because Minnesota has shown some real threat going forward. And they've shown they're exposing parts of FC Edmonton's defense. And then something's going to have to tighten up here, or these warning shots are troubling if you're an FC Edmonton supporter. But if you're a Minnesota supporter, you might say those are two chances we need to have taken.
0-0, 19 minutes on the watch at Clark Stadium. Minnesota getting closer to a breakthrough. See Edmonton have a goal kick this time.
If you take a look at Minnesota and that Justin Davis chances, as I said, they flooded men down that left side, and a couple of quick passes, a couple of quick one touches, and they free up some players, and that's their confidence they have in possession that they show, and that's very, very impressive for them. And when you can get those kind of quick passes in, you can really find some holes in the defenders. They just have to move and maybe can't keep up with the pace at which you're moving the ball around.
Navarro playing the ball out of defense there, but handing it straight to Giuliano. And there's a chance here for Jordan. Jordan sliding it to Ramirez, tries the snap shot, and that's going to be deflected behind for a corner kick to Minnesota.
Another poor pass from Navarro out of the back. Unusual for him, because he's been solid this year coming out of the back. And it looks like Jordan has a bloody nose. He's got to come off and get some treatment. Yep, he does. And so Jordan took a knock somewhere. The trainers are looking at him right now. So Minnesota down to 10 men temporarily. But some poor passes out of the back, just inviting Minnesota to come back and create chances.
Davis, who just rattled the woodwork, has a corner kick. He's put this one to the near post, and that's a good safe pair of hands by Lance Parker, nicely rolling it out for Lang. Good ball forward with the right peg, and he's found Jones. Jones has got Noni outside him, Amiobi in the penalty area. Noni just checks in field and waits for support to come from Burt. Chip ball nicely in for Amiobi, makes the turn, tries the cutback. That's some good football from the Eddies, and it's a corner.
And Minnesota's still down at 10 men. They're attending to Jordan on the sideline, so Edmonton has a numerical advantage right now.
Nice play by Amiobi there, good quick feet, and that earns him a corner kick, which Lance Lang will take from the far side of the field. And they've thrown the big center backs forward for this one, Watson and Navarro. Lang's ball has gone deep. Watson's the target, gets his head on it. Referee spotting another infringement in that penalty area.
I think he says that Watson pushed Diaz in the back.
Some of the crowd not very happy with that decision. Colin Miller having a word with the linesman here on this near side as well, but the free kick given to Minnesota, and it remains goalless, and we've played 22 minutes at Clark Stadium. Jordan's back on. There's blood coming from his nose. They're very quick to clean those types of injuries up these days, but he's okay to continue. He's back on the pitch. Navarro, lots of time to head that ball forward. Drop for Jones in the midfield. Just holds things up and picks out Edward. Chip ball forward by Edward. Eddie's getting crowded out in the midfield again there, so Rodales tries to switch flanks. With the captain, Watson. And that's a good ball to Amiobi. First touch, just let him down a trifle there, and the visitors back in possession, and Mendes chasing towards goal here, the number 18 for Minnesota. Jordan will have to to check back to retrieve that one, but still has possession. Now with Diaz. And it's Thiago, number five. It's going to go all the way back to the goalkeeper, Hildebrandt. And they'll find Diaz again, this time further out on the left. Minnesota using every part of the field, and now Giuliano trying a long ball inside the fullback, but Noni's equal to that one and heads it out to concede the throw-in.
So Hildebrandt kicking that ball out from the Minnesota goal, and he was sent off the last time these two teams played, and for taking down, I think, Frank Jahnke in the box. Again, that kind of wild and woolly 3-2 Minnesota win in Minnesota a few weeks ago.
Jahnke on the bench today for the Eddies. Diaz again in possession. Ibarra. With Aaron Pitch-Colan. Good pressure by FC Edmonton, forcing Minnesota to play it back to their goalkeeper again. Pitch-Colan trying a deft touch this time. Watson winning the ball back. And it's Chad Burt. Moses steps into this one. Finds Burt again, who seems to have dropped deeper. Challenged by Noni. Keeping possession for the Eddies.
Minnesota's really pressing the ball. Saw Noni there, three players on him. Anytime they sit to half Edmonton, there's players on top of them right away.
Long ball forward by Moses. Noni holding it down, and Jones striking it towards goal. It bobbled towards the goalkeeper in the end, but worth a pop. He's been in better form lately.
Yeah, a couple of goals in the last couple of games, and a real cracker a couple of weeks ago in that win over Carolina in Carolina. And wow, Carolina lost again at home last night. And a team that used to be automatic to win at home in this league can't win at home anymore. And it's been stunning to see Carolina's changing form.
Good pressure by Noni, winning a throw in right down by the corner flag here. And Eddie Edward coming forward to get hold of the ball for this one. Set play chance here for FC Edmonton. Burt comes over to win possession. Done well to twist and turn in there. Linesman says he's kept the ball in play. The cross cleared by Minnesota, but headed forward again by Watson. Amiobi gets his foot on the ball, and here's Lang. Lang tries to go past his defender. Good work by Venegas, but Lang doing a good job to win the throw in and gets things moving again to find Burt. Clever little back heel by Burt there, just couldn't quite find Lang. And it's Giuliano in possession. Away by Thiago. Navarro winning that ball, and it's Moses now.
You just see how the difference in approach with Minnesota, let's say, than when we saw Fort Lauderdale last week. Lance Lang was basically one-on-one with a fullback almost all game long and exploited that against Fort Lauderdale. Look at the numbers that are collapsing down that wing for Minnesota when Burt and Lang went down that wing. There were four light blue shirts for Minnesota there. They like to collapse around that ball carrier. They press, and we see two players here. One player in Edmonton's end, but always pressing that ball, wanting to make that the person receiving the pass make a quick decision.
Amiobi chasing over the top. The flag's up, though. That will be offside. Free kick to Minnesota. Still goalless. 27 minutes on the watch. Giuliano again trying to bring the ball out of defense. Pitch Colin picking out Thiago. Top there, which should be easy for Lance Parker. Quick rollout to pick out the skipper, Albert Watson. Edmonton just struggling to get the ball out of defense with so much pressure on them from the Minnesota midfield and attack every time they get the ball.
Yeah, it almost feels like the way Minnesota collapses to the, again, to the person with the ball, it feels like Minnesota has 13 or 14 players out there.
Mendez with some space on the right side. Lang's done well to make up the ground, and Moses will play the ball back for Parker. Parker's looking to find Burt. Tackled by Burt against Jordan, but Jordan rode the challenge, and he's got away down the right-hand side here. Excellent sliding tackle by Lance Lang to concede the corner.
You can hear that one from up here. The players coming together, but Lang getting ball first, so good clean tackle, but a hard tackle, I gotta tell you.
Davis with another corner. Good ball towards the far post, it beats everybody. Diaz back across the face of goal, and it's a bit of a let off again for FC Edmonton. Unable to deal with the initial corner, the ball bubbling around in there, but Minnesota not able to capitalize.
Yeah, when you let that ball bounce in the box on that corner, wow, you're looking for trouble, you're looking for all, but it just turns into a free-for-all, and that's exactly what happened. But Edmonton lucky that the ball caromed off a couple of their own players, and they were able just to scurry that away. But they're living dangerously, I gotta tell you, FC Edmonton.
Moses bringing the ball down the left-hand side. Burt on the chest, juggles with it for a bit, finds Amiobi. Navarro. Nicely on the chest for Edward. Noni again pressed very hard, being marked very tightly from behind. And he loses possession. And that's been the pattern of the first half hour of this match. There, he's done well to win possession back. And here's a break for the Eddies. Lang's away on the left-hand side. Amiobi queuing up in the box. Jones is on the edge of the area. Ball coming into the near post. And Jones is frustrated, as is Tomi Amiobi. Minnesota dealing with that one easily.
Rodales' outlet pass just wasn't quite strong enough for Lang. You had to see that Lang had to hold up and wait for it, rather than if that ball would have led him and he could have run onto that at full speed, he would have been able to get behind the fullback. But because Lang had to wait for that outlet pass to get to him, it allowed Minnesota to collect themselves and get men back.
Still 0-0. Jordan making a break forward here, trying to find a Barra. Dispossessed. And it's with Jones. Jones sprays a right-footed ball into the path of Noni. A nice one too. Noni's on the end of this one. He's tackled from behind well though. Very good defensive recovery from Justin Davis. It's a throw in for the Eddies. Could be a stoppage in play here though for the injury to Kareem Moses.
Not sure what happened. Obviously it's well behind the play here. It's the other end of the field and not sure if it's a cramp or something that happened earlier, but he's definitely in some difficulty.
FC Edmonton riding their luck a bit in this match. Here are some of the chances that Minnesota have spurned. This one by Ramirez after Moses's mistake. And Davis going very close as well, hitting the crossbar.
Yeah, and again, I think if you're a Minnesota supporter and you're watching this game online, you're thinking, wow, that's two let-offs. You know, that's maybe two that we should have. But Edmonton has been very fortunate because sometimes in the game when the team doesn't take its chances early, they get punished later in the match. But Edmonton really has shown some holes today and they've gotten away with it.
Looks like Moses is going to be okay. We'll try and get back on the pitch straight from the restart here. And it's an Edward throw in. Noni trying to go around the outside, linking up with Edward again. And Moses is back on the pitch now. FC Edmonton still in possession with Watson. Noni manages to work that ball down the right-hand side, but no one on the end of it. Great interception by Rodales. This is a nice pass into the stride of Lang. Lang's ball towards the edge of the penalty area will reach Noni, but the flag is up, and that's offside.
Yeah, he got burnt for the offside. Felt that his run was a little premature for that cross from Lance Lang, but Lang doing some good things. They're stepping inside to create some space for himself rather than carry on down the left. Burnt a step or two offside and the chance physics.
10 minutes to halftime, still goalless at Clark Stadium. Moses, good control on the chest. And a firm pass into the path of Lang. Lang trying to cut that one back into the path of Burt and winning a corner kick.
You see Albert Watson and Beto Navarro both going to join the attack here. Bigger center backs to maybe give the Edmonton a little bit more of an aerial edge. Well, obviously, Minnesota's got some big bodies in there when you look at their lineup.
Mendez just bumped there by Moses, but he's back up and able to defend this corner.
Not quite as tall as Fort Lauderdale. They had a basketball team back there last week, I'll tell you.
Jones with the corner. Looking for some movement in the penalty area. Michael Noni going to take this one. He's drilled this in towards the far post. Goalkeeper fisting it away, and Minnesota doing enough to get that one clear. Edward having the ball back here. He's lifted it long into the air. Moses and Amiobi causing problems in there, but again, the free kick given to Minnesota.
Cristiano Diaz saying that Amiobi used an elbow there. Trying to convince the official to maybe apply some supplementary justice there, or at least plant the seed. But honestly, this hasn't been a dirty game. It's been a good game. There's been some really good tackles in it. We've seen some good tough tackles, but... And I think it's emblematic of when these two teams play. These two teams have a healthy respect for each other. It's not like some of the other rivalries in NASL where things can get a little chippy. I can't really remember any incidents in a Minnesota-Edmonton game where you'd say something really dirty happened. These two teams, they play hard, but they are fair.
Corner kick for Minnesota. Kevin Venegas will take this one from that far side of the field. right-footed. And the yellow boot going towards the near post, and it's headed out for a repeat corner kick.
Emmy will be getting to that first short.
This time they take it short to Giuliano. Drive this one in low, and again, it's good defending from FC Edmonton. Noni's on the chase, just can't get there. Minnesota dominating possession in this match. Ibarra again full of running. Diaz will just roll this one back to his goalkeeper, Hildebrand. Forward by Venegas again. He's picked out Pichkola. Play switch to Mendes on the right side. Look for the first time cross, but well charged down by Moses.
And there again, I think we saw Minnesota string seven or eight passes together and then springing that chance.
Surprise throw there to pick out Pichkola. You can't be offside from the throw in. They took advantage of that. Didn't come to anything, but keeping the Eddies on their toes there. Nicely played by Venegas, cross to the far post, and very strong defensive play by Eddie Edward to keep that ball out of the Edmonton net and concede the corner kick.
And that was Christian Ramirez. He took that off the boot of Ramirez because that's where the cross was going. And Edmonton again averting some disaster with some last-second frantic defending. Again, you see what's going to happen when you let the other team have this much of the ball.
Davis rolls the corner short. It's drilled towards goal. Well defended in the end by FC Edmonton. Ibarra has a shot charged down too. He's still going though. Diaz whipping the ball in. This time maybe a bit of a respite for the Eddies as Lang streaks away down that left flank. Tries to pick out the running Richie Jones, but just a little bit too much purchase on the through ball and claimed well by the keeper.
Yeah, good play by Hildebrand there. Read that very, very early, was off his line very, very early to really take the pressure off his defenders there, where they knew that he was already at the top of the box, can grab that ball and turn it around.
4 minutes to halftime. The Eddies with a chance here. Strength in numbers this time. Rodales trying to dig the ball through. That didn't quite work, and Minnesota break again. Ibarra dispossessed by Watson. Noni turns and gets a free kick against Miguel Ibarra.
Might be close enough here for Edmonton to try to pump a ball into the penalty area and see if they can get ahead to it. And take a look. Noni brought down. So Chad Burt will be the one taking this. Navarro's come all the way up, so is Albert Watson again, the two center backs. So this is going to come into the area.
Towards the penalty spot, and that's going to be easy for Minnesota. Still goalless with about 3 minutes to halftime. Mendes has made a great break forward here for them, and he switched play to the edge of the area, and Miguel Ibarra, maybe a shooting chance for long range there, and Parker makes a fingertip save in the top corner. Very good play as Ramirez tested him from long range.
Again, good outlet pass here. Finds Ibarra. He's got space. He flicks it up to himself well, where he puts it in a good shooting position, and a really good save by Lance Parker.
Approaching halftime. Ramirez going close there, but Parker getting up well and making a very fine save. Corner kick, Davis with it. This one's been chipped up high, and excellent goalkeeping from Lance Parker.
Yeah, he came out of that mass of players and was able to get his arms and hold on to that ball.
Gonna need a bit of treatment there. It was a very brave claim. only one thought in his mind to come and claim that, take the pressure off his defense. And maybe getting bumped around a bit as he did so. Got his place back in the team. Had some good evidence there as to why, Steve.
Yeah, and obviously this year has been kind to Lance Parker in terms of injuries. With the finger problems he's had, it's kept him out of the lineup for a long period of time, and being able to win that number one job back in the last few weeks and won a couple of games, so we'll see how he is here. But yeah, he's jumping up in a big pile of players, very brave there, surrounded, got his arms up, almost a blind catch. When you're coming up like that, you're not going to see a lot of the ball. You just know where it's going to fall. You've got to get your arms up.
You see that save by Lance Parker. There's Ibarra with the ball on the left-hand side. Sees Ramirez in space, just touches it into his right foot. Good strike and a very good stop from Lance Parker. Back up on his feet, he's going to be okay to continue after this.
Well, it looks like just a collision there at the last second. Someone got him. It might have been one of his own players. I mean, in that mass of bodies, it's almost hard to tell, but certainly some brave goalkeeping, and now we get the game going on again.
There'll be a little bit of stoppage time added for that. Sounds like 2 minutes. After 45 minutes is up for the first half, which is right about now. 2 minutes of stoppage time will be added. Still looking for the first goal. Minnesota with a lot of possession and a couple of chances, but FC Edmonton very much in this.
Well, I got to think if you're FC Edmonton, this score holds going to halftime, you're pretty happy with the chances you've given up that you're still even.
Lang making another break down the left-hand side. He's going to strike from long range. Catches it cleanly, but not on target. Minnesota have done their homework on Lang, being very tight to it.
Yeah, and they bring numbers. That was the big difference that we've seen some other teams do. You know, when a player is a wing player, you're sometimes hesitant to bring help over because you're opening up the middle a little bit. But I think, as teams recognize the kind of threat that Lance Lang has been posing down the left side since he's made that switch to midfield from fullback, they're going to realize that you get burned so bad by him that you need to bring that extra body over, bring help over.
Ramirez playing one down the left-hand side here, looking for run off Davis. It's going to be a goal kick for FC Edmonton.
And Lang scored against them last time these two teams played as well, too, going back to that point. Again, that 3-2 game. He scored the opening goal that match.
Albert Watson finding Navarro. Moses just steps inside. Mendez and chips one up high. Again, that ball being held up in the wind. You can really see that. Wind blowing strongly into the faces of FC Edmonton in this first half. And that could be a factor in the second half when the Eddies will have the wind at their backs. Minnesota had the chances in this first half and haven't taken them. And it's goalless at halftime.
Between Minnesota United FC and your FC Edmonton Eddies. FC Edmonton fans, make sure to stop by and check out our new FC Edmonton Canadian Tire Community Trailer, located on the south concourse.
Players just walking off to the tunnel. We'll be hearing from both coaches here at halftime. Noni there just discussing how that went with Eddie Edward. The half where Minnesota They feel they should be in front at halftime. And we're going to hear from the Minnesota United coach, Manny Lagos, down there on the pitch. And hopefully he can join us right now. 0-0 at halftime. Let's hear from Manny Lagos. Thanks for joining us, Manny. Chances for your team in that first half. A lot of possession. How do you feel about the way things have gone?
Oh, I think from a soccer standpoint, some gorgeous soccer and some good moments. You know, maybe that killer instinct was lacking. So this next half is going to be important for us to come out and kind of play the same way and make sure on the final third we're better.
What do you say to the players? How much of a factor was the win, Manny? It looked like you had the wind at your back in the first half there.
I mean, we'll see in the second half. You know, again, for us, I thought we were moving the ball well. I thought we made some nice movements offensively in the final third. I thought our finishing was lacking. So we've just got to make sure that we continue to raise our level from the first 45 to the second 45, and I think we'll be fine.
Thank you, Manny. That's Manny Lagos, the coach of Minnesota United. His team unbeaten so far in the fall season, a stretch of 12 unbeaten games. This is always going to be a test for the Eddies. We're going to hear from Colin Miller, see what his assessment of this first half will have been for FC Edmonton. Steve.
Yeah, and here we have Coach Colin Miller. And Coach, Minnesota looked to have a lot of the ball. They had some really good looks on goal. How do you address this at halftime?
Well, we've got to stop giving the back to them, Steve. I mean, we've got some of their players, I think, are maybe looking for a contract at Minnesota. We've been so poor in possession. We work so hard to get it back, and we keep giving it back to them. And this is the best team in the league. If we keep doing that, we're going to get punished. No, we've played our get-out-of-free-jail card. You know, we're playing into a strong wind. No excuse. But, I mean, a lack of football awareness. I mean, why would you play a million short passes in your back four area when you're playing against a very strong wind? It doesn't make too much sense to me at all. Let's get it forward and put their back four under pressure. And I think when we've done that, they look very suspect. So we've got to try to put their back four under pressure the way we spoke about during the week at training. But I'm very, very disappointed with the amount of clear-cut chances that Minnesota have had. It's not good enough. I mean, I've said that this would be the big benchmark for us to see how close we are, how far away we are, you know, from being in that fourth place. And we still have some serious work to do here. I'm very disappointed in how we've played in possession and letting people run from the middle of the park. It's absolutely criminal.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Colin Miller really pleased with the way his team have hauled themselves back into the playoff hunt, but not happy with that first 45 minutes. We'll look back on the highlights after the break. 0-0 at halftime. Welcome back to Clark Stadium, where the game's nicely poised at halftime. 0-0 between FC Edmonton and Minnesota United. A good first half. Let's take a look back at the highlights from that first 45 minutes. Edmonton, their own worst enemy in the first few minutes. Here's Kareem Moses, and look at that back pass. In goes Ramirez, and you'd think he might do a little bit better from that range.
Yeah, Navarro is coming back there, but still, I think Ramirez, if he could have slowed it down a little bit and given himself a better look. Lang here, Giuliano clears that one out, crossed by Lang. Lance again coming down the wing, floating the chance up. This is Michael Noni trying to flick that ball back across the box, and the ball goes over the bar.
Another good chance for Minnesota later in that first half. Colin Miller talked about how upset he was with the defense, and there's Davis rattling one off the crossbar.
Yeah. And then we're going to find, look here, the last chance Christian Ramirez got. That forced Lance Barker into a really good fingertip save here. You see Ramirez able to step into the ball, and Parker just gets over. Really good goalkeeping there.
And that's where we are at halftime. Goalless, still anybody's match. So the fans looking forward to the second half, and it's coming up next.
FC Edmonton Soccer, starting now on City. Brought to you by City, the Fath Group, High Signs, and Earthwater.
Crucial 45 minutes this for FC Edmonton as they push for the playoffs. 0-0 in that first half. Minnesota squandering some good chances, so it's anybody's game, and they've got the wind at their backs in the second half, and we'll see just how important that could be, because Minnesota had most of the possession and the chances in that first half, playing with the wind. Manny Lagos talking about how he was pleased to see his team keep the ball on the grass for most of it, and Colin Miller hoping for a much better performance, not happy with seeing his defense give the ball away so much.
Yeah, and I think Colin Miller has every right to feel disappointed in the, some of the giveaways that Edmonton was committing, especially in their back four. But to be tied at halftime, considering really how badly Edmonton's outplayed in the first half, I think FC Edmonton fans have got to feel pretty fortunate about how things have gone.
See Edmonton attacking the goal to our right in this first half, and Chad Burt trying to get things going early on with a challenge from behind against Giuliano, but conceding the free kick. No substitutions yet, but Colin Miller will probably be thinking about them if he doesn't get the response that he wants from his team in the early stages of the second half. Chance for pitch Colin. He's just got in behind the defense and is well spotted by Eddie Edward, who came across to cover in the middle and concedes the corner.
That was good because Miguel Ibarra was sitting by himself in front of Lance Parker, and had pitch Colin been able to get that ball through, that's a tap in for Ibarra. So again, someone missed a marking assignment there, because Ibarra came in as the second attacker. No one picked him up. And if Edward doesn't get the deflection in, that's all sorts of trouble for FC Edmonton.
Defensive play by Eddie Edward, and it's with Justin Davis here from the resulting corner. Headed down by Watson, it might drop back for Davis, and he just drills it into the mixer. And Amiobi sticks out a left foot and gets rid of it. And Burt puts it behind for another corner kick. Good start to the second half by Minnesota, pinning back FC Edmonton. Two corners in succession here. Justin Davis will take another one from that right-hand side of the field. Driven this one in low, Amiobi again, defending nicely. It's going to be with Giuliano. He's got time and space to pick a pass. Left-footed ball into the box. Edward gets a header away from it. Burt helping it along, and it's with Noni. Burt, in the end, spraying a nice pass out to the left flank. Lang's on the end of it. Lang's got support in the penalty area, and he just couldn't get the cross in before being tackled.
Giuliano stood him up well there. found a spot, so you're not going to get past it. Got a foot in, clean tackle.
Ibarra making a run from midfield, but can't get on the end of that one. Navarro finding Watson. Watson pushing that one through the middle, but that's what Colin Miller was lamenting in the first 45 minutes. Another loose ball from the back. He's got away with it, and it's Moses making a break down the left-hand side. He's tried to pick out Lang. Lang will not get to it, and it will be a goal kick.
Hildebrandt running a bit of an interesting screen there, almost timing a slide to miss Lang and miss the ball to sort of slow down Lang from any possible chance of catching up to that ball.
Goal kick for Minnesota. Still a strong wind into the goalie's face. And you can see he's barely got that one past the halfway mark. Pitch Colin flicking it along. But it's back with FC Edmonton, middle of the field for Rodalis. That's up high in the sky. Ami Obi gets a good flick on it. Just drops to a Minnesota player. Ramirez trying to turn Watson there. He's done well, but again, very good covering by Eddie Edward, who's been forced to run across to the middle a couple of times in the second
half.
Yeah,
he's actually made a few last-ditch tackles even in the first half as well. I think he'll go back and think of a couple of interceptions. So he's been alert, and we talked about some of the giveaways to the back. He's helped clean those up.
Ibarra inside the penalty box. Edward trying to close him down. Ibarra to the edge of the area, but that's not a good pass. And Burt is on the end of it. And now Eddie Edward. Linking up well, takes it around Ibarra. Referee Alain Rouche awards the free kick to Edward. Not too much doubt about that one. And that's the Eddie's ball. Just touched it by him, and that's maybe in frustration more than anything else.
Yeah, let's Edmonton slow it down just a little bit, because the second half has begun a lot like the first did, with Minnesota putting a lot of pressure on the Eddies. You can see the fouls are 7-2 for Edmonton, but this hasn't been a dirty game and by any stretch of the imagination. I think those fouls just illustrate how much the ball Minnesota's had when you're at 7-2 for Edmonton in terms of fouls. And it shows you how little of the ball Edmonton's had. But that's only, was that the second or third foul of the game for Minnesota? So can't get fouled when you don't have the ball.
There's Rodalis in the middle of the field hoping to have more of the ball in this second half. And Richie Jones just dropping a touch deeper. Sliding it for Watson to step into. Watson's given that one away. And back come Minnesota. Mendez turns to find Diaz. And now pitch Colin. Jordan back on the pitch again. He's had some problems with a nosebleed in this match. Ibarra trying to get in behind the back. Edward watching him very closely. And taking the ball away from him. Very good full-back play from Edward. And Ibarra fouling him for the second time in a minute there.
Yeah, Ibarra, again, a little bit of frustration. He's lost the ball a couple of times to Eddie Edward. But, you know, go back a minute there. When Albert Watson gives that ball away, and I think if you want to have an answer why Christian Ramirez has scored so many goals, as that ball goes off his foot and Ramirez reads that there's no Edmonton player in the area, he's already making a break the other way, trying to make himself available for a ball down the middle. He's reading that play and attacking. Didn't come to anything, but it just shows you that a striker has to read giveaways.
Here's Rodalis, turns in the middle of the park. Now Watson. Long ball forward to the chest of Ami Obi. Well controlled. Burt turns and makes another chip pass forward. Diaz getting his head on it, but they're a little rattled there, Minnesota, and forcing themselves to concede the corner kick this time. Good response from the Eddies.
Nice friendly side bounce there from the ball to bounce for a corner rather than a throw in. Side spin on the ball helps the Eddies there.
Michael Noni taking this corner kick. The home fans trying to give their team a boost as they prepare. It's to make this set play.
Interesting that Lang's not taking it. He's in the top of the box instead.
Doesn't beat the defender, but Noni will get a second bite of the cherry. Curled this one to the edge of the box. Jordan winning the header. Dangerous break here from Minnesota. Ibarra's held that one along. And it's a good interception towards the end there by Lang, who put the pressure on. And the shot blazed wide of the post.
Yeah, Lang gets on his horse and uses that speed that he has, maybe one of the quickest players in NASL, just to get back and bother the shooter just a little bit. But again, Edmonton living dangerously.
53 minutes gone, still goalless. Minnesota going close again as Watson, under pressure, concedes a throw in. Good throw by Davis. They're not watching it as Ramirez gets in behind and picks out Ibarra. Eddie Edward recovers well, concedes another corner kick.
Do you see a scoring chance? Can you just call up the guy's number in case I miss it?
Again, we see Aaron Pitch-Colin right front and center for Minnesota on this attack. And again, a player with various teams has really haunted FC Edmonton over the years with some big goals.
Venegas with this left wing corner. It's gone deep, headed back in towards the 6-yard area, scrambled away by the Eddies. Noni's got possession, there's nobody with him, and all he can do is drill it upfield. Davis plays it back to his goalkeeper.
He's just trying to scramble to relieve the pressure. That's all he's trying to do there. And that's really what Edmonton's been left to do with Minnesota's pressure and possession.
I will not be able to keep that ball in play. Another throw in for Minnesota, who just put so much pressure on the ball. Closed down all the space that FC Edmonton have found it very difficult in this match. It's always going to be a big test for them, and it's turning out to be. Colin Miller describing Minnesota as the best team in the league and saying at halftime, if his team continued to make mistakes, they'd be punished. Diaz bringing the ball out of defense with aplomb there to the edge of the penalty area. Ibarra will get on the end of this one. Ramirez trying to play it back into the path of Ibarra, but a bit of a communication breakdown there, and the goal kick is the Eddies.
I think Edmonton got a bit of a help from that breeze there. That cross went out to Ibarra and looked like it just got really held up there and just hung in the air for a little bit. And I think the wind had an effect there, that Eddie Edward get over and get those extra second or two to get over to Ibarra. Again, just Minnesota with so much of the ball.
Navarro accomplished in possession, bringing the ball forward for the Eddies, but again, it comes to nothing. It'll be another goal kick for Minnesota. Not any sign of Minnesota slowing down in their play, though, Steve, even though they're guaranteed a place as the spring champions, they've continued to impress.
No, I think they definitely showed they want to have home advantage all the way through the playoffs or championship, whatever the, you know, the NASL calls it, the championship. And I think as well, just for their fans, I mean, I think they feel they owe it that to keep that intensity up. And they've done well. They certainly haven't taken it easy in the second half of the season. They've been a real credit to the league as a whole.
Playing well at Clark Stadium today and showing just what a good team they are as Giuliano strikes one just wide of the post in a well-worked set piece. That's come straight off the training ground. Good movement, nice interplay between the Minnesota attack there to open up that shooting chance.
Again, just another couple of quick passes and then it's set up there for Giuliano to have the strike. And luckily for Edmonton, it goes right by the post here. And you have a quick look and see how close that was. Maybe a foot.
Another good chance gone begging for Minnesota, but they're surging forward again here. Jordan trying to play it in behind Edward. He's got a hurried pass back to his goalkeeper there, and this could work out well for the Eddies as Burke makes the break in the other direction. Trying to play a nice through ball for Jones, and then did get it through in the end to Tomi Aniobi, but the free kick given against Noni, and that's a moment of controversy in the crowd who don't believe that was a fair decision.
No, because I think Aniobi was in alone when the whistle blows there, but Diaz was down. The first ball from Burt doesn't go through, but he gets a second little kick at it. Yes, Jones is in offside position, but I think he's passive. He's on the wing. That ball's not being played to him. The ball would have been played to Aniobi coming through.
Perhaps the referee feeling that Burt just showed too much studs in the tackle there. That's all I can really think. Could be a bit of a let-off there for Minnesota. About a half hour left in this match, and it is 0-0 at Clark Stadium. Noni hobbled off after that challenge. He's on the sidelines waiting to come back along. Colin Miller watching very closely from his position, standing in the dugout in the technical area.
Well, Noni's actually nowhere near ready to come back on. He's on the ground now. And Hanson Boakai's run over to the bench and he's stripping off, so it might be time for Boakai to come in the game.
Venegas pushing on inside the fullback. Pitch Colin's found some space. Chance in the penalty area there for Mendez, and he's put it over the top. It's going to be a goal kick for FC Edmonton.
Another good chance for Minnesota. They're just piling them up, and luckily for Edmonton, I don't know what it is today, but Minnesota is not had the shooting boots on. Every other part of their game has been excellent, but here we see the turn and not really close to goal with a chance.
I think we've seen the end of Michael Noni. That was a little bit more serious than we first imagined, that challenge. He is not coming back, and so Hanson Boakai is going to replace him. He's just getting some last minute instructions in the dugout there from Jeff Paulus as he waits to make his entry here, Hanson Boakai. And they'll wait for a break in play, and that will happen right now. So here he comes, Boakai, giving the crowd a lift. They like to see him play. I'm sure his orders will be to try and run at the defenders.
Yeah, just to use some of that speed and guile that he has, and ability to skip by players and see if he can bring some life or inject some life into a team that really needs it, actually. Because again, you look outside of, you know, the decision that went against Edmonton with the tackle on Burt, that might have been the only good chance they've created. And Minnesota's had a couple of decent looks again in this half. You know, it's really, look at Minnesota's five or six really good scoring chances they've had.
Yeah, FC Edmonton a bit fortunate still to be level, but this game all to play for, 0-0. Boakai is on for the last half hour of the match. Davis being ordered back by the referee, just stole a few more yards there, taking that throw in. Aniobi's done a lot of good defensive work for FC Edmonton. He's closed a lot of balls down. He's done well marking from set pieces in his own penalty area, but not a lot of service in terms of creating chances or scoring goals in this match. He's been a little alienated up there.
Yeah, and that's just, again, a symptom of how much Minnesota's had the ball and how much they've pushed Edmonton back. It's been a bit of a thankless job for Tomi Aniobi today. He's just had to do a lot of fruitless running.
There's Boakai getting his first touch. Poise on the ball there as he takes it back. It's Rodales, middle of the field. Tries to switch play to the right wing, but that wasn't his best pass, and it's an easy pickup for Minnesota's goalkeeper.
Well, again, Edmonton has a couple of moments there where they put a couple of good passes together and then really just trying to force something that's not there.
Diaz. Finding Davis. Run back by Edward there, and Diaz has been pulled out of position. There's Boakai. Kareem Moses with a bit of time and space to find Albert Watson just crossing halfway, and now it's Edward. Edward choosing to go back to his skipper. And now Watson, an accurate chip ball forward to Burke, who miscontrols it. And Pitch Colan has the ball for Minnesota. Almost sold his central defender a touch short there, and Rodales put some good pressure on him, and FC Edmonton have the ball back. Navarro getting good reviews from Ramirez facing him this week, saying that he finds Navarro one of the toughest players to play in the NASL. Certainly done a very good job for FC Edmonton since signing at Clark Stadium. There's the possession, 56% to Minnesota, 44% for Edmonton. And that's not a surprise.
Not a surprise. In fact, if there's anything I'm surprised that the margin isn't wider. It feels like it could be 60-40 or something like that, or 65-35, the way the game's gone. But still a pretty sizable advantage for Minnesota.
Jones, pass along the deck for Burt. Burt's giving it away. It's breaking down in a critical moment. Frustrating for FC Edmonton this match. Pitch Colan making a break inside the fullback. Lang's putting the pressure on him, steals the ball away from him there. And that's well played by Moses to release Burkai. Slipped it through for Amiobi. Amiobi gets into the penalty area, holds it up well, tries to get the ball across the face of goal, and it's tapped in at the far post. And FC Edmonton have a goal. Chad Burt with a volleyed finish, a deft touch after some wonderful work by Tomi Amiobi. And FC Edmonton lead 1-0.
You know, against the run of play might even be an exaggeration here, but Minnesota may be paying the price for all the chances they've missed. Boakai finds the pass, finds Amiobi, who does a great job holding this thing up, and then the deflected ball finds Chad Burt. And then a little back heel flick, and it's 1-0 to Edmonton. And, you know, we talked about in the first half of the year how all these breaks seem to be going against the Eddies. And I think if this result holds up, or Edmonton gets something out of it, and Edmonton player though is getting treated after I think it's Richie Jones went down after the goal, you have to say, wow, this time there is a, they did get a break. They have got the breaks. That is Richie Jones.
Chad Burt's name being announced to the crowd, and that was a class finish. Lovely touch at the end. Real smash and grab raid from FC Edmonton. Counter-attacking down the left. Amiobi, who's done great work all game, finally gets a chance to run at the defense. His cross takes a deflection, and what a finish from Burt. Volleying it into the back of the net and giving his team a 1-0 lead against the unbeaten Minnesota United. 66 minutes gone, and the Eddies 1-0 up.
I see Jones is back on. He's got his treatment, so he's okay. Didn't see it, obviously, with the goal happening, what happened with Richie Jones, but I think knowing Richie, he'll take a little bit of pain knowing that that attack ended up in a goal for FC Edmonton. But again, you know, talk about, you look at this game now and you say 66 minutes in, and you would look at the amount of dangerous chances, and Minnesota's by far the more dangerous team, but didn't take advantage. And Manny Lagos said at halftime, you know, we did have the killer instinct. And all it takes is one chance, and that happens.
Boakai tackled there. Crowd feeling like it should have been a free kick.
And that attack began. Let's go to Boakai's great pass to Amiobi to put him into that area. Boakai found that pass. And Amiobi did well just to hold it up, to wait for some help. And yes, the cross was deflected, but he still was able to keep possession of the box to get that ball over.
Very flying play by Boakai, and then Amiobi. setting up Burt, but it was a deft finish. And that is the lead for the Eddies, who will try and hold on to it now. Rodales is penalized there for a slightly late tackle on Ibarra.
And then with that goal, it's $100 that goes to the Salary Children's Hospital.
Davis from the left-hand side. Ibarra's got in behind the back. Ibarra with a shooting chance. Terrific block from Albert Watson, threw his body in front of it. And at the other end, Boakai's made a great break. And Jones might just get on the end of this. And he does get a touch, but very fine anticipation by the goalkeeper. Amiobi knew he was offside and walked back and allowed Jones to make the break, nearly a second goal there.
And what happened, Minnesota's back line walked back with Amiobi, thinking Amiobi's offside, we're okay, and didn't pick up the fact that because he's passive until he touches that ball, Jones is running onto it from well out to try to create something. Almost a lapse there by Minnesota in understanding the offside rule that could have put Jones in the clear, but Hildebrandt was pretty alert to get that one away.
Minnesota just feeling a little bit frustrated up there at the moment. Manny Lagos up in the technical area and not pleased with the way things are turning out this afternoon for his team. Edwards throw up the line to Amiobi. Very nearly slipped it through for Jones again, but it's a throw in for the Eddies. And they decide to wait for Edward to take it. Amiobi, nice flick. Jones into the path of it. Jones has to hold up. There's no one in the box. He's got a chance now to cut it back. Oh, look, I just couldn't get on the end of it. Watson watches it. Edward makes a terrific run down the right-hand side and wins a throw-in. Eddie Edward for FC Edmonton. Leading 1-0 against the spring champion, Minnesota United. Burt, 1-2. Very nearly released Boakai through the middle. And a tackle from behind. He's won the ball back. The Eddies goal scorer is Boakai. Referee makes a nice touch that works out well for Boakai. Tries to thread it through, but it'll drop for Lang on the left wing. Lang makes the dummy and shoots right-footed and has curled one into the top corner. And FC Edmonton are on fire all of a sudden, leading 2-0. Lang on target.
I tell you, it's amazing what a goal can do and how it changes a game. But really, the referee changes this play because Minnesota has that ball out. It bangs off the back of the referee, comes back to Boakai, who finds Lang way out in the wing, and Lang curls a perfect shot in. And right now, this is Lance Lang's world, and we just live in it, because how hot he's been has really been incredible. And boy, does he pick the top of the net there.
What a beauty from Lance Lang. Onto his right foot. Not supposed to be his favorite foot, but he buried that one. What a curler into the top corner. And it is a 2-0 lead for the Eddies. Lang adding to Burt's earlier goal. They've scored two in 6 minutes and lead Minnesota. Amiobi putting the pressure on again as Diaz clears. Watson, the skipper, getting that ball back through the middle. There's going to be a handball given against Giuliano, and the Minnesota team just getting a bit frustrated at the moment.
But really, on a positive side, when we talk about FC Edmonton, the biggest change even from the spring season, the last couple of seasons, Edmonton would have to create 10 or 11 chances to get one goal. And now they get two sniffs, and they've got two goals. It's amazing how this team has changed in terms of taking its chances and being... And this is why the goals are now flowing for this team, where we're seeing two and three goals a game from FC Edmonton, is because there's so much confidence around goal. They're having a go. And really, from a couple of half chances, they've got two goals.
Lance Lang's been such a part of the recent form of the team. and he's on the score sheet once again. And when scoring first, there you can see it, FC Edmonton only losing one out of five, winning the other four. So that's a very important statistic. They tend to go on and get 3 points when they score first.
And if this score holds up, and as much as we talk about how Minnesota dominated the first half of this game.
It's a header by Lance Barker coming off his line, and Mitch Colan chose to go first time with the volley, and he was very close, but he couldn't hit the target.
That's a let-off again for FC Edmonton, because Mitch Colan had a gaping wide net to put that into. And he cushions that. Why? You can see there's no one in that goal.
Minnesota throwing caution to the wind. They're going to make a double substitution when they get the opportunity here. Coach Manny Lagos bringing on two new players to throw what he can at FC Edmonton in the last 15 minutes or so.
But what's going to happen is if this score holds up, if Edmonton gets the 3 points, people won't just recognize the fact that this team has won three in a row or five of the last six. What they're going to say is, wow, they just beat Minnesota. And look at how they're tightening up the standings. And it really, it's a message sent throughout the league. And the coaches and the other teams will all be paying attention.
Jordan and Ibarra replaced by Omar Dealy and Rafael Burgos.
Now entering the match, number 19, Rafael Burgos.
But it's just been amazing how this game's been turned on its ear.
Good ball forward by Edward to pick out Burt. Couldn't quite keep it in touch. Throw in for Minnesota. Moses steps inside his marker. Playing it forward, Amiobi winning that battle again. He's played a terrific match this afternoon. Good match by the Eddie center forward. The Eddie's conceding a free kick there, though, through Lance Lang.
Just a little bit of a clumsy collision. Again, nothing dirty in that. Just Minnesota playing the ball now, forward. And now it's going to be Minnesota's got to gamble and take chances.
Last 15 minutes, Edmonton leading 2-0 at home against Minnesota. Kareem Moses with the throw, looking for Amiobi again. There's the substitute Burgos helping that ball along, looking for Ramirez, but Albert Watson defending well. Navarro with time and space to clear. And he's just hit that one up the left channel. It'll go into touch. Frank Jonke is going to be coming on momentarily, replacing Amiobi. I think that's just a question of a fresh pair of legs. Amiobi has covered almost every blade of grass this afternoon. Certainly a very strong performance by him and creating one of the goals as he breaks towards goal again here. Good pace as he tries to take it around Diaz, but good recovery from Diaz. Burt's got it back. Tricky little pass to Jones. Amiobi again. He'll wait for support, and he's got it from Chad Burt. Brought down from behind there. Yes, he does. Referee gives the free kick to FC Edmonton. And that will be the last of the action for Tomi Amiobi. Fine game, and Jonke will replace him.
Yeah, and I think that's, like you said, it's just, he's run miles today. It's been a thankless job, but he sets up the first goal. So job well done by Tomi Amiobi in the end, and he can get that well-deserved round of applause from the fans in attendance today, and a handshake from the coach.
On comes Jonke, and he'll be a physical presence against Minnesota for the last 13 minutes. Hurts free kick, curls up to the far post, easily claimed by Hildebrandt. Good pair of hands from the goalkeeper. Good work by Jones, blocking the pass from Diaz. Just short of 3,000, 2,796. Jones just backpedaling, lost his balance there at a crucial moment, and he can smile about it. It's a good day so far for his team and for FC Edmonton. Free kick right on the edge of the penalty area. Watson felt like he was the actual victim there, but the free kick given to Minnesota, and this could be a lifeline for them right on the edge of the 18-yard box.
Yeah, it's all the one problem is that sometimes when you're right at the edge of the box, you almost wish the free kick could get a couple more yards back to get it up and down. Sometimes I think that I would love to see the teams take an option if there was available. I think a lot of shooters would pull this back a couple of yards to give them a little bit better of a chance to get this up and down. Because when you get really this close, and you have to get it up over the wall and then down again, it's a bit tricky. It's actually a little bit better angle to be a couple of yards back.
It's Mendez and Venegas over the ball here. Mendez hits it, he's got a great curl on it, and he scored a beauty. And Minnesota have hauled themselves back in this match. Mendez picks the top corner, and it's 2-1.
And just as I say, is the angle we better? If it was further back, Mendez proves me wrong with a perfect free kick into the corner of the goal, and you can see it swerves. Lance Parker, not much chance there. And Minnesota right back in the game.
Christian Ramirez being replaced by Simone Brachialello for Minnesota for the last 10 minutes. And they're very much back in it now. 2-1, the deficit. Hustle by Eddie Edward there. Manny Lagos sensing his team have got a chance now, and he's up with words of encouragement in the technical area. It's Pitch Colon. Well, that was about as good a free kick as you would see from Mendez. Lovely execution, great strike, and not a lot that Lance Parker could do about that.
Yeah, and again, as I said, it's not that easy when you're right across at the top of the box, because you got to get that up and down. And that one held a nice true line and swerved, so well-taken kick. Now Edmonton's got a lot of work to do. They still have 9 minutes plus time added on, and they got to hang on to this.
Rodalas bumps there after pushing the ball up to the left-hand side, and that's the first portion of the match going to Venegas, a yellow card for that challenge.
We see Rodalas, yeah, and then Venegas is up. Rodalas is back down the pitch again.
$737, if that's your ticket number, please take it over to the information trailer on the south end of the stadium.
Well, it's going to be a nail-biting last 8 minutes for the Eddies fans. All of a sudden, you can just sense a bit of anxiety throughout Clark Stadium. Navarro's forward pass, headed away by Venegas, who just went into the referee's notebook. A lot of urgency now about Minnesota. Brachialello playing a ball forward with the outside of his right boot. And picking up another substitute, Daly. Omar Daly playing it into Giuliano, and that's a ball that will drift over the top. Tried an interesting cross there with the outside of the boot. It didn't quite work.
No, it actually just became a bit of an interesting thing there for Lance Parker. You saw him have a look at it and thinking, is that going to drop on me? But
he's got the time, coach.
We'll see here. Are we already in the point of the game where Lance Parker is going to be not in that much of a hurry to take the goal kick? We're in the 83rd minute now, so.
Not sure if Parker's carrying a bit of an injury, but Navarro's the one who kicks it up the field. Jonke jostling for the ball. Pitch Colin heading it along. Rodal is miskicking a pass. And it's Navarro again, gets his foot on the ball and finds the skipper, Albert Watson. Watson, forward pass to Boakai that he controls very well and curls a ball out to the wing and Lang. Lang onto his left foot, early cross, little drop for Burt. Edge of the area, Boakai right-footed shot. And it's picked up by the goalkeeper. Just probably didn't drop to his right foot.
Good movement though by FC Edmonton to get Boakai that look at the top of the box. Lang getting that ball across, switching it back to Burt, and then Burt, nice little ball at the top of the area for Boakai to run onto.
Watson heading one into touch, buying his team a few more seconds.
Manny Lagos is hollering at his team to get up there, keep moving, keep attacking, come with more men.
Burt just laying one off for Boakai on his weaker right foot, an easy save. Eddie's leading 2-1, last 6 minutes of the game here. Thiago, long ball over the top, that's easy for Parker. Doesn't need to head this one clear under pressure. He'll kill a few more seconds. Chad Burt gets another touch on that one. Jonke will chase it down. Diaz playing it back to his goalkeeper. Drives that one up the pitch. Navarro winning the header. Good footwork by Burgos there, and Pitch Colin trying to push that one along. They've got another free kick in exactly the same position, and this spells danger for the Eddies.
Yeah, and I think we're pretty sure who's going to be taking this one. The same person who scored the goal right from almost exact same spot. And here we see Burgos forward, and they get Moses for the shove there on Mendez. So Mendez will get up and he'll take this. There's no mystery here. They can have a few men standing over the ball. If you just popped one in the corner about 2 or 3 minutes before, you're taking the next one. There's no... So I don't even know why Minnesota would bother having multiple men over the ball. He may as well get Venegas just to move to get somewhere else, because Mendez just scored. Why have mystery here? He's going to be taking this.
The sweetest of strikes as well for Mendez.
Even if Venegas takes this, I don't understand this at all. I really don't.
Venegas and Mendez over it. We know what Mendez can do. We just saw him curl one into the top corner, rising when it hit the net. Referee worried about a bit of argy-bargy in the middle there. And just making sure players know the rules of engagement. He wants a word with Beto Navarro.
He's got the time.
Mendez and Venegas. Free kick here for Minnesota. It's Mendez again. He gets it on target. And Lance Parker makes the save.
I think as soon as that ball's off in the foot, everyone's heart's in their throat because they see it's on goal. But Lance Parker gets enough behind it and keeps it out. Everyone can breathe again.
Got a good strike on it again, just not the direction this time. Horace James is going to be coming into the game for the Eddies when there's a break in play. And this will just kill some valuable seconds as well, this substitution. Another fresh pair of legs, and Chad Burt, who scored with that deft touch, is going to be replaced by James.
Yeah, and James will give the team a chance to maybe hold the ball up. He can get some runs going through. He's a very quick player.
will cause some pressures as a runner in the Minnesota end. And Minnesota complained to the official here, I'm not sure what about. But a couple of players really in the ref official's face here.
Chad Burke shaking hands with his manager, Colin Miller, as he sits in the dugout. Meanwhile, Lang tries to take the ball into the corner, and as well a free kick for FC Edmonton, which they won't be in a hurry to take. Minnesota want to get on with the game, and they're feeling like Edmonton's wasting a bit of time here.
You'll have a look here. It's Mendez, and Mendez does kick out. I mean, that's a cardable offense, really. You know, you kicked him in the shins pretty hard there. You know, there's a lot of referees. That's a yellow for, that's a straight kick to the shin. So I don't think Minnesota, I can understand you're frustrated that the player's down and you're gonna say he's wasting time, but that's a pretty clear foul.
Yeah, not too much doubt about that.
See here, Mendez. And this just whacks him right in the shin.
Yeah, like, he's not got anywhere near the ball. Really, that is a yellow card.
Yeah, definitely a card. In my book, that's a dirty play, to be fair. It's dirty.
Well, they're just going to pull this into the corner flag. And concede the free kick in the end. Tactic that some of the fans don't like to see, bringing the ball into the corner there. But with a minute left of the 90, that's what the Eddies are doing now, is running down the clock. Easy header for Watson from the danger zone. Boakai takes a touch, beats his man, plays an accurate pass to the wing, and Jones has got all the time in the world. He waits for James. James will run into the corner, but it goes out for a goal kick.
Touches a bit heavy. Edmonton there. Jones does the right thing. He slows it down, realizes I've got time here. I'm going to kill some time, but heavy touch from James allows the goal kick. You want to be able to pin that ball in the corner.
Edwards got a chase on against Daly here. Edward will get to it first. Slips down. Referee sees no infringement. Great recovery by Eddie Edward. That was just pure guts and grit, as we've come to expect from Eddie Edward.
He has had a very good game. You know, we've talked about some of the giveaways in the back, but Eddie Edwards had some good interceptions, good defensive blocks. It's been a thankless job for Eddie Edward today, but I think one that he's done well.
Terrific performance from Edward. There will be 5 minutes added on. We've played 90. FC Edmonton have 5 more minutes to hold off Minnesota. Another great tackle from Eddie Edward, playing a blinder out there today for the Eddies. Throw in by Davis in towards the near post, and Arca has to fist that one clear, and Rodales doesn't really get a good clearance on it. Diaz has a throw in, gets on with it quickly. Davis harried from behind by Jones. He's managed to win his team another corner. It's going to be 5 agonizing minutes for FC Edmonton.
I think agonizing being the key word. Minnesota's really turning the screw right now, looking for that equalizer.
Venegas' corner kick to the far post. That goes past everybody. And will run out of play. Throw in for FC Edmonton. They won't be in a hurry to take this one.
No, but they also got to make sure they got to get this deep. They can't just get pinned in their own area. Most important thing is to get a clean throw to someone. They can get this down the field and relieve the pressure a bit. Minnesota's got, they're all over the place here, looking to see if they can get on top of a short corner and turn this ball over again.
Throwing down the wing, flicked on, Boakai chasing it.
Not sure
he wants it retaken. I don't know if the ball might not have come in play.
Yeah, I think that's what he's saying, is that actually never crossed the line. That
I'm not sure if it came in play.
Well, Moses doesn't get a good throw on that one, but Lang flicks it along, and Jonky does too. And Boakai is putting the pressure on Diaz, but Diaz has scrambled it forward to the edge of the area. Watson just puts it in the stands where he knows Minnesota cannot score from. And they've got another throw in. Davis throw into the penalty area. Odalas again, header away. Jonke getting a tackle on Diaz. Ball going into touch, and Odalas appealing for a free kick. I think the linesman flagged for it, but the referee
shook
waved
him off.
It away.
Shook him off, that's exactly right. Diaz had the hand up to push Rodalas down, but I think the referee felt that Rodalas made more out of it and slid down fairly easily and said, no, I'm not giving that.
Another throw in for FC Edmonton, Kareem Moses.
Moses can't possibly take enough time to take this throw in. I think that's what they're thinking.
Venegas winning it back, though, until Rodalas gets on the end of that one again. Picks up Jonke. Jonke is tackled and has a throw in. And FC Edmonton now have 3 more minutes of stoppage time to negotiate. They lead 2-1 against Minnesota. Goals from Chad Burt and then from Lance Lang. Minnesota getting back in it with a Mendez free kick. And that's where the game stands. 2-1 with 2 minutes left of stoppage time. Thiago playing it forward. Moses, another header away from the danger zone. Free kick given against him as he jumps up to win it again. And Minnesota will throw everyone forward now, trying to protect a 12-game unbeaten streak. And it's Venegas who will take this free kick. Everyone in the penalty area. The goalkeeper is almost on the halfway line. Hildebrand for Minnesota. It's a ball that he's just thrown into the mixer. Edge of the area, strike from Bracalello. He's high, wide, and handsome. It'll be a goal kick.
Yep, and I think now we're going to see Lance Parker is going to look. Can he get Beto Navarro to take this for him? And Beto's going to have to go and place the ball. Got to find just the right spot on the turf. When you're leading, this is a gamesmanship. When you're losing, this is so frustrating.
Deep into stoppage time now, the very last minute of the match. Jonke chesting it into the path of James. He'll just take this into the corner flag. Horace James. That's what he's done. He's just going to try and keep it in there as long as he can. Got dispossessed, but he's got support from Jones, and they win themselves a throw in, the Eddies. And that is the final whistle, and FC Edmonton have themselves a major scalp here at Clark Stadium today. Rode their luck in the early stages, all kinds of chances for Minnesota. But then a goal against the run of play by Burt just gave Edmonton so much confidence. Lang doubled the lead, and although Mendez pulled one back, it's 3 more points for FC Edmonton, who are now well and truly in the playoff hunt. Stay with us. We'll continue with our post-game show after the break. Welcome back to Clark Stadium, a 2-1 victory for FC Edmonton over Minnesota United. Minnesota's unbeaten streak is to an end. We're going to go pitch side now and join their coach, Manny Lagos. Manny, thanks for joining us. You talked at halftime about lacking a killer instinct for your team. What do you put it down to today, losing this one?
Yeah, I think we started the second half very well again. I thought we were on the way up, and I think just by missing the chances we did again, I think the game got stretched, and I think Edmonton came in the game. So credit to them, once the game stretched, of taking care of those chances and kind of getting the lead. So, you know, it was a good day for them. I thought, like I said, we had our chances to take really momentum of this game in certain parts, and we didn't. And when Edmonton had their chance, they did.
Thank you again, Manny.
Thank you.
Manny Lagos, always very honest as he talks to us during and after the games, and feeling like his team played well, but as he mentioned at halftime, just didn't quite have a killer instinct today.
No, again, it's not a question how many chances you make, it's how many you take, right? And Edmonton didn't create as many chances as Minnesota, but they took them. And that's the key to this one. And in the long run, it's 3 in a row for Edmonton, and a message sent throughout the league that they took out Minnesota today.
Colin Miller's team well and truly on a tear now, really in form, playing with confidence. Let's hear from the coach, pitch side, Steve.
Coach, an interesting win, maybe not as comfortable as maybe some of the other ones in recent time, but still you have to say it sends a message to the league that you've beaten Minnesota.
Well, yeah, it's not comfortable because we've played against the spring champions, a team that are well-organized, well-coached, well-prepared. We had to do, I said today that I don't care how we win, I just would like to get 3 points because it would send a bit of a statement out. And we made it difficult for ourselves and take nothing away from Minnesota, but the first half our performance was poor and the guys knew that. So I actually worked up a sweat with what I was going on about at halftime. In the second half, the guys were more competitive. We were better in possession. I'm not saying we were the finished article, but we created one or two more chances and looked dangerous on the counter-attack because the final ball was better. And if we're going to compete at the top level of this league, then you know we have to be better in possession. Our organisation, our discipline, our fitness is all as good as any team in the league. But the top teams in the league don't give the ball away as easily as we did at times in the first half. But the second half performance, our guys were, I thought, terrific. Gave absolutely everything for the cause. And a thank you to all the fans that turned up here today.
But again, now you look at this playoff race, and it's super tight. And it's both the fall season and the overall. Just now you look forward to every game now.
Yeah, 9 games to go, Steve. A long way to go. Our policy has been one day at a time, one training session at a time, one 45 minutes at a time, which we were poor at in the first 45 minutes. And we've come out and we've won the second 45. So, and that's how we'll do it every game. You know, we haven't arrived. We will have a, maybe I might have a Guinness tonight, maybe one or two. But I think it's our preparations. It's not getting carried away. I don't want the players to look at leagues. I don't want them to, you know, one of the negative things about us playing on a Sunday is that we see what goes on a Saturday night and a Friday night with San Antonio. But so if we just look after our own house, that's the most important thing. We've got our own destiny in our hands here. We don't want to look at leagues and say, oh, yeah, we're up at this position, that position. We take this one day, one training session at a time. All cliches.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thanks, guys.
Coach Colin Miller, well pleased with 3 points against Minnesota. 2-1 victory for FC Edmonton. Let's take a look back at the highlights. Brought to you by Cap City Landscaping. The grass is greener. Well, FC Edmonton riding their luck in that first half in particular.
Okay, here we see Hanson Boakai, and he's going to unlock it with a great pass here to Tomi Amiobi. And Amiobi holds up, waits for help, and then deflected in the box. And then we see Burt come over with the side foot and puts it in.
See Edmonton, though, still having to do good defensive work, and Watson throwing himself in front of that one. Saw several great tackles by Eddie Edward in this match, too. Here's Boakai again, though.
Here we have the assist by the referee. The ball comes back off of him, and it sets it up for Lance Lang. And Lang, I don't know if there's a hotter player in the NASL at the moment. No, I don't know, all apologies to Christian Ramirez, but wow, did Lang finish that chance off.
This one, a free kick on the edge of the area, and Mendez, what a beauty.
Yeah, absolutely curls it in and had another look right after that. But 2-1, Minnesota deserved a goal for all the chances they created. And here's the one that Mendez curls in and Parker gets behind.
Lance Parker standing firm for his team. For FC Edmonton, coach Colin Miller talking to the club's owner there, Tom Pfaff in the sunglasses. He's a happy man today with his team on the charge in the league standings. Let's see where that places FC Edmonton after this 3 points today, and look at the way the table's changed in the last month. They're in fourth place.
Yeah, and only 5 points out behind San Antonio, and they play San Antonio next week. If they could go on the road and get a result, wow, does this tighten up.
The defensive player of the game today, we're about to show you. More danger for Minnesota. And a very fine claim for Lance Parker.
Yeah, he was shaken up a bit on that play, having to jump up and just pick that ball out.
But he got a fine performance by Lance Parker. The players dancing on the pitch. This is a great day for FC Edmonton. Next match coming up the 21st of September. The Rowdies will be in town.
thanks for joining us today. 3 points for FC Edmonton, a big victory, a 2-1 win home to Minnesota. Good night.